Hello, today we are going to install Windows 11 with Vert.io in a QEMU Vert Manager virtual machine. So first of all, I'm going to use the official Windows 11 ISO, which you can download. So you search on Google Windows 11 ISO, download Windows 11 disk image ISO, 64-bit, download now, choose a language, English US, confirm, and then this is the link to the ISO file. Then we need the Vert.io ISO file. I search for Fedora People Vert and ISO. It takes me to the correct place. What's the newest one? 2023 January. Okay, so let's go here. Let's see if there's a sim link to the latest version. So there's such a thing, latest Vert.io. Okay, so January 2023. And also a sim link, which is Vert.io Win ISO for 510 megabytes. So let's go with this one. I'm going to put it where I put ISOs. Okay, let's see the speed. 4.9 megabytes per second. Okay, I can start creating the virtual machine. So I'm on Kubuntu 23.04, which is a Linux operating system. I have installed Vert Manager, which is named the Virtual Machine Manager. Let's open this up. File, new virtual machine. Local install media ISO or CD-ROM, that's one. Browse. Let's do a refresh. Win 11 2022 H2. It automatically detects it as Microsoft Windows 11. Suggests the minimum, which is 8 gigabytes of RAM, random access memory. So let's go with 10. And the CPU cores, let's go with way more, I don't know, 14. The hard disk image, let's make it 250 gigabytes. Maybe more, let's go 300. Suggests a name Win11, which is okay. I want to customize before install. The Vert.io ISO has finished downloading, so we'll need to add it as a second SATA CD-ROM, add hardware, storage, CD-ROM, SATA. I want a ISO, which is named Vert.io Win version and then ISO. Choose volume, SATA, because the Windows 11 installer does not know about about Vert.io, and it's okay with me. Finish. So let's look at the virtual machine settings. Win 11 correct, UEFI without secure boot, we can go with that. The newest motherboard Q35, CPUs, let's make this correct. So one CPU socket, 14 cores, memory 10 gigabytes. Boot is going to boot from SATA the next time. So first time it's going to boot from the CD-ROM, then after it first reboots, it's going to boot from the disk. Okay. The disk should be vert.io for speed. We keep in here the defaults, so this is the Windows 11 ISO installer media. Vert.io win ISO for vert.io drivers. Network interface card, the best one, which is vert.io. Tablet, yes. The rest are defaults. And this was added by Vert Manager when I selected Windows 11 as the operating system. So Windows 11 requires TPM version 2.0, which is Trusted Platform Module. It's emulated, so it's a virtual, not hardware. It looks okay the way the virtual machine is configured, so I go begin installation. It's allocating the virtual hard disk. It's booting for the first time. Press any key to boot from CD. The mouse is still grabbed. The mouse is not grabbed anymore because probably it has detected the USB tablet. So English next, install now. I don't have a product key. Windows 11 Professional. It accepted the fact that maybe I do not support secure boot. Who knows? Maybe I do support secure boot. EULA. Install Windows does not detect the virtual hard disk because the Windows 11 ISO installer DVD-ROM does not know about vert.io. So I need to go load driver, browse. Vert.io, okay, it doesn't find it, so I need to dig a bit deeper. AMD64, Windows 11. Okay, so it says that my hard disk, my virtual hard disk, is of type vert.io, Red Hat vert.io, SCSI controller, from /AMD64/Windows11/VOStore.inf. Next. Says that it has seen my virtual hard disk, 300 gigabytes, pre-selected. I just press next. It has formatted the virtual hard disk of type vert.io with GPT, GUID partition table, not with MBR. My firmware for this virtual machine is UEFI, not BIOS. The installation is formatting, creating partitions, copying files over, and then it's going to reboot a couple of times. Because it's a virtual machine, the installation is faster than probably on a hardware machine. And my CPU is new, and it's on DDR4 RAM, so PCIe 3 NVMe, so it's fast. Let's wait a bit to finish copying files. It says installing features. Checking for updates. And it's going to require that I reboot. I go restart now, not to wait 10 seconds. Now the ISO for the Windows installer has been removed from the virtual machine settings. So it has booted from the virtual hard disk. Let's check this. So the SATA CD-ROM is still mounted, the first one, but the boot options do not include booting from DVD ROMs. So it's just booted from the virtual hard disk. Okay, so this is the first time Windows 11 boots from the hard disk. It still did not create Windows user accounts. So we'll wait a bit. I'll be back in a second. Okay, the Windows 11 installer has rebooted. And now we have a different part of the installer shown on the screen. English US, please. Okay, so I cannot connect to the internet because my network interface card, my only network interface card for the virtual machine, is of type VirtIO, and Windows 11 installer does not know about VirtIO. I do have the CD-ROM with the drivers mounted for VirtIO, but I'm not going to install the Windows drivers for the network interface card because I want to install Windows 11 in such a way that I connect to Windows using a local Windows user account, not using a Microsoft online account. Okay, let's connect you to a network. How are you going to propose to do that? Okay, there's a way to skip this page, and I do not know which is, so I'm going to research and I'll be back. Okay, so I have searched the internet. So on Google, Windows 11 installer, the text that's shown here. So let's connect you to a network. And it says people also ask, how do I bypass? Let's connect to a network on Windows 11. And it says that I should press Shift F10, which I know it is going to open the command prompt. And then I need to run this command. OOBE bypass on RO. So let's look at the page. So I'm here. It's showing me step by step how I installed the Windows 11. And then in here it says Shift F10. So let's see if this thing works. If not, we're going to try something else. Don't we have auto completion? Yes, we do. Backslash. Okay, so this thing probably OOBE out of the box experience bypass on NRO network requirements or something. CMD, so this is a command prompt cmd.exe batch file. The computer will restart automatically. The out-of-the-box experience OOBE, which is probably in the installer, will start again. Part of the Windows installer. Okay, so again, English US. Let's connect you to a network. I don't have internet. And it's for the better, of course. Connect now to quickly get started on your device. Sign in with Microsoft. I do not want to sign in with Microsoft. Get email. I do not want to get email. Work across devices. I do not want to work across devices. Enhanced security. I do not want enhanced security. So continue with limited setup. So this is the name of my local Windows user account. I cannot go administrator, so I'm going with admin. Password, extra complicated one. Security question, random things. Okay, I uncheck everything in here. This is a virtual machine that I want to be fast. Accept. Okay, so this is the wizard that we see after the while the local Windows user account is being created, and this is the equivalent of copying files from /etc/skel, so skeleton, into your home directory on Linux. So it's creating a registry hive, a directory in /c:\users for the user admin. And then it's going to log me in into that user account. Let's pause it for a bit. Okay, and it has logged me in. This is how Windows 11 looks out of the box. I'm going to terraform this virtual machine, and then I'm going to connect to the virtual machine not using the virtualization software, but using a RDP protocol client, so remote desktop protocol client. So let's terraform this machine a bit. I do not know how to do it. Taskbar settings, this one, yes. Taskbar. How do I put the taskbar on the left hand side of the screen? Let's. Okay, what else can we do? We do not have yet a network interface card. So let's do that. So Windows Explorer. I have started it by pressing the Windows key plus the E key. So the Windows plus E key combination. Let's go to the drivers for vertical. No, where do we? Actually, we do it from here, from the device manager. So right click on the Windows Start menu, Device Manager. It says that it would like to install drivers for 3 hardware devices. So let's do that. First, we do the Ethernet network interface card. I go browse the Virtio DVD. Next. Has searched the entire DVD. It has found the most appropriate Windows 11 64-bit driver for the network interface card of type Virtio, so Red Hat Virtio Ethernet adapter. I go close. Now it says just 2 more devices which do not have yet a driver, which are probably going to be Virtio devices. So update driver, browse. Next, so /E:\ was already selected, which is the CD-ROM with Virtio drivers. Update driver, browse, next. And this is the Virtio serial driver, close. Okay, so all of the Windows 10 device hardware that does not have a device driver were under, I know, unknown in here in Device Manager. There's that category does not exist anymore. All of the hardware devices have a accompanying Windows 11 driver, so everything's perfect in here. So this is the network interface card. Okay, let's see if we have networking. Yes, because the virtualization software offers a DHCP server. What do we need to do next? How do we hide the search? So no search because the start menu does have a search, so it's enough for me. I don't know what task view is, I don't know what widgets is, I don't know what chat is. Let me actually put it on the left side. Where are you? Align left. Okay, so it looks better now. Let's do the mouse cursor. It's too small. How do we do that? Additional mouse settings, pointers, Windows default extra large, apply, okay. Let's install updates. Let's disable automatic updates first. So we need the GPO, group policy, administrative templates, Windows components, Windows update. This thing. Configure automatic updates disabled. So I can install updates. I do not need Windows to automatically install them. Let's actually install some updates. Check for updates. Go. Okay, while it's doing that thing, let's remove the icons from the taskbar that I do not want. So Microsoft Store, Microsoft Edge, Windows Explorer. Let's start to install some software. So I'm forced to open Microsoft Edge. I don't want to stay up to date. Start without my data. Start browsing. Okay, let's install Firefox. Download Firefox. Okay, open the file. UAC user account control is enabled by default. Great. Let's see if updates are installing right now. So they're installing. I'm not sure if I can install both updates, Windows updates and Firefox at the same time. It seems I can. Set Firefox as default, don't import anything, save and continue. I don't want to hop from laptop to phone. Okay, so it's already pinned. Let's move it at the first position. Okay, we do not need Edge anymore. So let's remove it from prominent positions, from the desktop. Shift delete. Okay, let's configure Firefox while it's installing updates. Where are you? Customize, so this thing, that thing, that thing, and that thing. Never show bookmarks, and two settings. Tabs. So this should be blank page, and downloads should always ask. Okay, let's find out, let's enable remote desktop. Where is that? System. Advanced system settings, remote, allow remote connections. The user admin is allowed to connect remotely. Apply, okay. What's my IP address? I don't know, let's find out. CMD. Okay, so it's 122.95. So let's connect to this virtual machine using a RDP remote desktop protocol client. I'm on Kubuntu 2304. I have installed FreeRDP, the RDP client, remote desktop protocol client. So that's xFreeRDP -- help. Let's prepare a command line in a text editor. So we need a command line like this one. User is admin. IP address is 192.168.122.95. Byte width 1080p. Okay, what other goodies can we have? So clipboard is redirected by default. We do not know the password. We want sound. So this thing is Pulse from Pulse Audio. We want the best protocols, so video. So optimized remoting channel for video. This means that YouTube is going to work better in the virtual machine. Okay, what else? We did sound, so we have sound from YouTube in virtual machine. We have the size, width, and height. We need this thing for best performance. Okay, what else? Network for best speed. So the best speed is LAN, local area network. We don't need a microphone. I'm using English US as a keyboard mapping. So we want GFX. What else? Two more. So DPP. BPP, which means bits per pixel, 32, and the last one, the resize support. Dynamic resolution, this one. Okay, let's look at the command line. So xvrdp is the name of the executable. It's going to connect to my Windows machine using the local Windows user account named admin. It's going to use 1080p screen resolution. This is the machine that it should connect to, 192.168.122.95. I want to hear the videos from YouTube, if I'm going to ever run such a thing in the virtual machine. Best performance possible, these four settings. And then dynamic resolution means that if I resize the screen of X3RDP application, the Windows 11 machine is going to change its resolution dynamically. So let's use this command line, paste. So it says I can connect to the virtual machine. It's the first time I'm connecting to it. It has the wrong name, so let's rename the machine. So system, rename, where are you? Right click, system. Rename this PC. So let's name it exactly the way the virtual machine is named, so Win11. Restart now. So I'm not going to connect using RDP because I do not want the old name to be recorded in the on the hardware machine or the host machine. So I go Control C to kill the connection. After the virtual machine has started, I'm not going to connect to the virtual machine using the virtualization software Virt Manager anymore. So I can actually close the window. I can close all of the windows of the virtualization software. Okay, so let's connect. Now it says that the name of the virtual machine that I'm connecting to is Win11, which is correct. Do I trust? Yes, I trust. So I have typed uppercase Y, and now it requires the password of the admin user. It has connected. It tried to set the resolution 1080p, but it did not manage because out of 1080p, this part is used by the KDE Plasma main panel, and this part is used by the application X3RDP. This is the title bar. So it actually resized the resolution of the Windows machine to less than 1080p. Okay, can we clean something up in here? I know. Uninstall Clipchamp. Uninstall Mail. Uninstall Maps. Uninstall News. Uninstall Teams. Uninstall To Do, etc. So a ton of software that needs to be uninstalled. And all of this software will reappear once Windows 11 updates itself, which is probably on the way already. Check for updates. So it says that it will install updates for Windows 11. So I can restart it now or wait a bit. Let's do a bit more terraforming, and then I'm going to reboot such that the Windows 11 updates can be installed. So once I have Firefox installed, my next steps are to use Firefox private window, which will pin itself. So Windows Firefox private window. Once you start it for the first time, it has pinned itself to the Windows taskbar, which is okay. I need to install some minimum software on all Windows machines. The first of all is 7-zip. Let's go there. So 7-zip. Otherwise, I cannot extract things, archives, or compress them. Okay. It's very small. Installs very fast, downloads very fast. Okay, the next thing, I do not want to use Windows Explorer, so I'm going to install an Orthodox File Manager, which might be either Total Commander or Double Commander. Let's go for Total Commander this time. 64-bit only. English, no other languages. The correct install directory. I do not want icons on the desktop. In the start menu, it's okay. Okay, let's start Total Commander. Okay, press button 1. Let's configure it. So no function keys. What else? No button bars. Okay. Show hidden and system files. Operation, mouse, right click, left mouse button, Windows standard. Okay, edit, I do not have yet a text editor, so I need to get that. Quick search, you know, letters with search dialog, I usually use letter only. And that's all of the settings that I do in Total Commander. Let's pin Total Commander and place it on the, you know, the first or the second position. Into taskbar. Also the, so I have three icons pinned. I have Firefox, Total Commander, and Total Command, oh, and Firefox in private browsing mode. Looks okay. So I need a text editor. Let's go for KD's Kate. On Windows, release 64-bit. So I'm going with 64-bit, not exe because that's an installer. I'm going with the 7-zip one. Let's create a directory for this thing. So C. What do I use in here? Temp. New folder bin. Okay. Let's go there. So temp bin. Extract kit. Right click. 7-zip. Extract. Okay, let's shorten this name, or not. It's okay like this. And the executable is this one, kate.exe. So I go configuration options, edit view, and I'm not going to use notepad.exe because this is way too limited for a text editor. So I'm going with kate, this one. So C colon backslash temp backslash bin backslash kate and then backslash bin and kate.exe open. Okay, and now if I want to edit a file, which a file I do not have. Let's create a file, a.txt. It's going to edit it with Kate. Okay, Ctrl W to close. Okay, and that's most of the steps that I take in order to install Windows 11 on HGMU virtual machine, to connect to it using VRDP, XVRDP. So I'm not using the virtualization software to connect to the virtual machine. I'm actually connecting to the virtual machine using an RDP client. The same I would do if I would connect to a real machine that's remote. So I'm treating my virtual machine as a remote hardware machine. Okay. I have an Orthodox file manager, web browser, unzipper editor. The next thing that's going to be installed in here, if I decide that this is going to be a development machine, I'm going to install development tools such as the Difference Viewer, WinMerge. Okay, and then if I'm going to do Windows development, sysinternal suite, Microsoft Visual Studio, etc. So I'm going to start installing updates. Can we tell it to not show recommended file applications in the start menu? Let's see. So that's suggested. System clipboard. No, in taskbar settings. There used to be a setting that said show suggested apps in start menu, which I know how to find it on Windows 10. I do not know how to find it in Windows 11 because I do not know how to use Windows 11 yet. Start settings. This thing. Show recently added apps. Show recently opened. You need to activate Windows before you can personalize your PC, so some Windows settings are not available to me because I'm using the Windows 11 official ISO file from Microsoft, and I said I do not have a license key when I installed Windows 11. So I'm not going to activate it. I'm going to just use it like this. As long as Windows allows me to use it, then I'm going to reinstall the Windows machine, the virtual machine from scratch. So installing Windows 10 from scratch and setting it up should take less than 90 minutes. Okay. More recommendations. If we go to more pins, do we get rid of Netflix? So they're maybe not installed, but ready to be run. All of these unneeded applications, and they're also pinned. Facebook Messenger. And as far as I remember, once we install a new version of Windows 11, all of these recommendations will appear. All of these applications will reinstall themselves. Uninstall. You cannot uninstall Windows Edge. Microsoft Edge. Okay, how do we unpin all of these at once? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Not like this. Okay, so I need to click a ton of times just to remove all of these not needed things from the start menu. Okay. So I'll finish that and I'll install Windows updates, which requires reboot. And then it says that installing this cumulative update will take 4 minutes. Then I'm going to need to install the next Windows updates. Okay, so this is it. This is how you install Windows 11 on QEMU Virt Manager in July 2023. Thank you.